So how are you doing?
Still training to be a pro league duelist.
That was the original plan, but now I'm not so sure.
What are you talking about? You've always told me how you've dreamed of traveling the world to face other pro league duelists, and now you're just gonna throw that away?
I don't know, it's complicated.
Come on, what's wrong?
What?
Don't love me. You're only like this when you're thinking about someone.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, you do. Could it be Darian?
Jerk, you know I hate it when you bring up his name.
I know, but I always love that look on your face when I do. Anyway, I have to go to Sullivan's card shop. There's a new Duel Monsters pack that comes out tomorrow, and I want first dibs.
Mind if I come with you?
Sure. Just arrived today. His hit helps young duelists with training. Don't worry, I'll have the manager set it down to one for you.
Very funny.
Duel Bot? Perhaps using the Duel Bot will help me get what I want.
Try it first, or should I?
I can give it a go.
Go for it!
Identification. Evelyn. Duel mode. Engage.
Let's duel!
I set a monster face down. Then I set two cards face down and end my turn.
My turn. I send Rockstone Warrior from my hand to the graveyard. To special summon Power Giant. Now, attack!
Due to Sangin's effect, I can add one monster card from a deck to my hand as long as its attack points are less than 1500.
Before I end my turn, I summon Shell Knight.
Does not compute.
I know. Zero attack points. But when Shell Knight is summoned, it switches to defense mode, and then you take 500 points of damage. My turn is over.
My turn. I set another monster.
Again.
Turn complete.
Draw. Power Giant, attack his face-down monster.
Due to Deep Diver's effect, at the end of the battle phase, I can choose a monster card from my deck and place it on top.
I end my turn.
Commence draw phase. I activate the spell card, Sword of Revealing Light. Due to this card's effect, you cannot attack for 3 turns.
I guess it's stalling for time.
Turn complete.
My turn. I play the spell Miracle Rupture.
By sending Weathering Soldier from my deck to the graveyard, I can draw a card.
Damn it. I have nothing to destroy his Sword's Revealing Light card. I have no choice but to end my turn. I'll pass. There's nothing I can do.
Commence draw phase. I activate Heart of Greed. With this card.
You can draw 2 cards. I think the manager needs to program that explanation out.
Draw. I activate the spell Card of Duality. Due to this card's effect, I can excavate the top 3 cards from my deck and add 1 of them to my hand. Because of Card of Duality, I'm not permitted to special summon any monsters this turn. I set a monster and end my turn.
About time.
All right, waiting time is over. I play Cyclone to destroy your source of revealing light. Now, Power Giant, attack his face down.
Due to Scalangle's effect, I can draw one card from my deck.
The Duel Bot's strategy doesn't make sense. All it's been doing this whole duel is adding cards and playing defense. Wait, adding cards. I better stop this and fast.
Before I end my turn, I play Hand Destruction. Now we must both send two cards from our hands to the graveyard and draw two new cards. I think I figured out the strategy.
It was planning to summon Exodia, the Forbidden One.
You are correct.
So that's why the Duel Bot's been playing defense, to try and gather all five pieces of Exodia.
So say goodbye to two of your cards, Duel Bot.
Great job, Evelyn. That should stop that rust bucket from summoning Exodia.
Ha! I wouldn't celebrate too soon.
Darien, what are you doing here?
This is the jerk.
The one and only. Hey, wait, I'm not a jerk.
Cut the crap and tell me why you're here.
I just came here to see who will win. You or the Duel Bot.
Well, you just missed the first half. She just stopped that tin can from summoning Exodia.
She did, huh? I expect nothing less from my future wife.
Don't make me barf, especially in the middle of a duel.
I say we make another wager. You beat the Duel Bot, you can go free. If you lose, then you're mine.
What happened to our last wager? Last time I beat you, you promised to leave me alone.
Did I? I don't remember making such promises.
Now I know why you hate this guy.
You just can't handle my good looks.
Sure, that's what it is.
So what do you say, Evelyn? Do you accept my wager?
Fine, I accept.
Yes!
Evelyn, I have total faith in you, but if you lose, I'm not being your bridesmaid. Now kick this robot's iron butt!
Will do. My turn is over.
Processing countermeasures.
Now that this robot can't summon Exodia, defeating it should be a breeze.
Countermeasures received. Initiate Ultimate Lord strategy.
Say what? The Ultimate Lord?
In order to summon the Ultimate Lord, I must return all the monsters from my graveyard to my deck. From my hand, I special summon Exodius, the Ultimate Forbidden Lord.
How come its attack points aren't determined?
Exodius gains 1,000 attack points for every normal monster in my graveyard.
But you have none, meaning its attack points are zero.
Incorrect. Now I activate this spell, Foolish Burial. Due to this card's effect, I send Tryon Drain from my deck to the graveyard. Now Exodius gains 1,000 attack points. Next, I'll send Cookie Ball from my hand to the graveyard in order to equip Exodius with the Twin Swords of Flashing Light Trice spell card. The equipped monster loses 500 attack points. However, it can now attack twice per turn.
That was a waste. Your Exodius isn't strong enough against my two monsters.
Your logic is not valid, for I have a solution to that problem. I activate the spell. Stop defense. This card switches your Shell Knight from defense to attack mode. I now activate Exodius's effect. When I declare an attack with Exodius, I must send one card from my hand or deck to the graveyard. So I send the right arm of the Forbidden One from my hand to the graveyard. Now Exodius gains another 1,000 attack points. Exodius will now attack Shell Knight. Go, Exodius Blast!
I activate Shell Knight's effect. When it's destroyed, I can add a level 8 monster from my deck to my hand.
I don't think so. By discarding Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring from my hand, I can prevent you from adding a card from your deck to your hand.
No!
Now, Exodius, attack Power Giant. I send the left arm of the Forbidden One from my deck to the graveyard to give it an extra 1,000 attack points. Go, Exodus Blast! turn complete.
This is bad. She only has 200 life points left.
I know. And that means soon she'll be Mrs. Derry.
You know you make me want to gag, right? My turn.
I set two cards face down on the field. That's all I can do.
Commence draw phase. Evelyn, the probability of you surviving this round is 0%. Now, Exodius, attack her life points directly. I send Exodius' left leg from my hand to the graveyard to give it 1,000 attack points. This duel is over. This does not compute. Your life point should have dropped to 0.
It seems your probability calculation was wrong. And it's all thanks to my defense draw.
Your probability of winning is still low. I can keep going. I'll have Exodius attack again. I set the right leg of the forbidden one from my deck to the graveyard to give it another 1,000 attack points. Now attack her life points with Exodus Blast. Error. This does not compute. Your life points should have dropped this time.
Thanks to impenetrable attack, I don't take any battle damage during the battle phase.
Turn complete.
I draw. First, I set a card face down. Then, I activate Fossil Fusion. I'll fuse my Power Giant, your Twihorn Dragon, and your Graveyard. Summon Fossil Dragon Sculpius!
No!
I'm guessing Evelyn's about to send this Duel Bot to the scrap heap.
Now that I have Sculpius out, defeating Exodius and that Duel Bot shouldn't be a problem.
The probability of Evelyn using Fossil Dragon Sculpius effect is 100%.
For once, your calculations are correct.
Therefore, the only solution to stop Scorpius is to neutralize its special ability.
Say what?
Reverse card open. Infinite impermanence. Due to this card's effect, Fossil Dragon Scorpius' effect is negated for the rest of this turn.
No matter. I'll just use Scorpius' effect on my next turn.
It matters not, Evelyn. With only one piece of Exodia left, this duel is over.
How? Four pieces of Exodia are in your graveyard. Therefore, you can't win.
Incorrect. Exodius has another effect. If all 5 Exodia cards are in my graveyard because of Exodius' effect, I automatically win the duel.
Oh, shit.
I can hear those wedding bells ringing now.
Ending duel now. I draw.
I don't think so. Since this is your standby phase, I can activate this. Card Thunder of Ruler!
Now, you can't conduct your battle phase this turn.
Turn complete.
My turn. This is my only chance to take out Exodius. I set a card face down, and then I'll attack with Sculpius.
I activate the trap card. Negate attack.
No!
Due to this card's effect, your attack is negated. Cancel out. Null and void. Denied. Revoked. Rejected. Seized.
Okay, I get it. I end my turn.
Commence draw phase. From my hand, I activate this spell, Bat Ruler No More. This card negates all of your monster's effects until the end of this turn. Because I activated Dark Ruler No More, you take no battle damage. But that doesn't matter. The probability of you losing and becoming Darien's wife-to-be is 100%.
Excuse me, what?! Did you rig the Duel Bot, Darien? You jerk! That's cheating!
So what if I did? You're gonna lose, Evelyn, so get ready for the wedding of your life!
Sorry, Darien, not gonna happen. Because I play my face-down prepping war.
Damn it!
No matter. On my next turn, Exodus will...
There won't be a next turn for you.
Your logic does not compute. You have 200 life points remaining.
Well, this move is gonna be a game changer. Come on, Evelyn!
Don't get your hopes up. I bet she'll draw a bad card.
Draw.
I activate Pot of Greed.
First, I reveal Fossil Fusion in my hand.
Then I send Valkyrion the Magna Warrior from my hand to the graveyard.
In order to activate, Specimen Inspection. I choose a monster type and level, and if you have a card that matches, it goes straight to your graveyard. So I choose Spellcaster, level 3.
Yes! And since Exodia's head was sent to the graveyard by a different card, the Exodia's victory effect doesn't work. Well, Darien, looks like your wedding plans are about to be cancelled.
Don't count on that just yet. Exodia's is still stronger than her Skulkios.
Not for long. Now I banish two rock monsters in my graveyard in order to summon Gaia Plague the Earth.
Your strategy does not compute. Exodia's has more attack points than your Gaia Plate. Therefore, you lose.
Sorry, but the only person or robot who's going to be losing here is you. Any monster Gaia Plate battles loses half of its attack points. Now, Gaia Plate, attack Exodia's! Now, Skulkios, end this duel now!
One day, Evelyn, you will be mine.
But before that, you've got some explaining to do. Thanks to you, the Duel Bot needs to be reprogrammed. You're coming with me.
Hey, lay off! No one makes a fool out of Darien! Nobody!
I don't know until you're doing a pretty good job yourself.
Evelyn.
Hey, Evelyn.
Hey, Kasara. How are you?
I'm all right. It's been a while since we've seen each other, and I want to hang out with you. That is, if you want to.
Yeah, sure. I'm free Saturday.
Saturday? Yeah, I'm free Saturday.
Okay. I'll text you the location.
Great. I'll meet you there.
Who was that? A friend of mine. Seen her in a while. I wonder what she's up to.
They don't really mean, really mean. Oh, you're only everything I ever dreamed, ever dreamed of, ever dreamed of. You must be kidding me. Did you really think I could say no?